Oh, don't worry. We're ready with three orchestrations of Love Makes the World Go Round.
Oh, good.
Come here, come here.
Hi.
Hi. Listen, would you do me a favor?
Oh, you look beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
What's up?
I'm worried about him.
Oh, I know. I can't believe it's almost a year ago. He and Skye were married right here.
Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on him.
Okay.
Have you seen Daddy anywhere? You know, he's a sucker for rose blossoms.
Mm-hmm. Hillary, listen. Weddings are only romantic for your spouse.
Well, today I happen to be an optimist. Listen, good luck. Give Cindy my love.
Right.
See you later.
Thanks.
I tell you, nothing is sacred anymore in this world. Look at all those women with naked hands.
Aunt Phoebe, isn't it a beautiful day for a wedding?
Young lady, where are your gloves?
You know what? I think they're about to start. We should go sit down and be a real family.
I'm an usher. I don't think...
That's okay. I mean, Aunt Phoebe, you're part of the family, right? So let's... Head on down.
Watch.
The flowers are so beautiful.
Hello, sweetheart.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello, Phoebe.
Langley?
I'm in charge of the seating for this family. So, Aunt Phoebe, why don't you sit right here, please?
Thank you.
Thank you. And, Daddy, you know, this happens to be your seat right here. You can just come sit down right here. There you go. That's it. Okay, see you later.
On our wedding day?
I am going to be happier.
That is impossible.
Excuse me. Frankie, you're bugging me, okay? Don't worry about it. The wedding will take place in the
people
are whispering about me. I know they are.
Relax. Nobody's whispering.
Who giveth this woman?
I do. What you did at the last time. You just walk down the aisle and throw some petals a little to the right, a little to the left. I'm going to just try just a few. Oops, save some for the profession. The procession.
Oh, you look. Okay, everybody, I see it's time.
You can't blow it.
God, you'll be fine.
Cindy, you stay upstairs. Let me make sure everything's okay, okay?
Yes.
We're ready and waiting here.
Oh. Wait, that's so bad.
Hi, sweetheart.
Oh, Mom.
Look at her.
You crying, Mom?
No, I can't cry. I'm happy enough to cry gallons, but I don't want to ruin all this beautiful makeup.
Good thinking.
I could do with a good luck kiss, though. Mm. I love you.
I love you, too.
Well, I guess it's time.
So do I. Well, I guess I'd better let them know.
Thank you. Are you okay? Mm. Stuart's waiting.
I know.
Oh, well, kiddo, this is it.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses, men and this woman, in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate, instituted of God, and signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any man can show just reason why they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter, forever hold his peace. Cindy, will you have Stuart to be your wedded husband, to live together in holy matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep you only unto him for so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Oh, me! I do.
I love you.
Me too.
Stuart and Cindy have decided to say their own vows. Stuart?
Every morning when I wake up, I thank God for sending you to me. You're brave and strong and gentle and kind and also beautiful inside and out. I never thought I'd be lucky enough to be standing here next to you saying, I do. But I do, Cindy. I love you with all my heart. And I love Scott. And I'm very proud to have him as my son. Your family is my family and mine is yours. And I want to be with you every minute I can. And I promise you that I will love you forever. Even longer than forever. That's how I feel. Amen.
Cindy?
I've learned that life is uncertain. But I've been blessed to find a man who can teach me and guide me, protect me. You have a wonderful gift to make people see themselves and things as they really are and still love what they see. In sharing that with me, brought me a peace I didn't know I could have. With you holding my hand, I can see the uncertainties. I want to face them. My strength is your strength. My love is your love. Now and always.
Amen.
May I have the rings? Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings. May they who use them abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor. In Jesus Christ our Lord, amen.
Take this ring as a sign of our love, which will never die.
Will last longer than forever.
For as much as Stuart and Cindy have consented together in wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined together, may no man put asunder. Amen.
I love you, Uncle Stuart.
You may kiss the bride. Kiss the bride.
Thank you.
Stuff in the greedy bellies, eh?
Oh, I guess he's never going to let go of you, is he, ever?
Oh, that's all right. I don't really want him to.
So how does it feel to be in a fairy tale?
Like, I don't have to worry about dragons anymore. Ooh, isn't he handsome?
Oh, he certainly is. But you're asking the wrong person for an objective opinion.
You were terrific, Stuart. And the things you said, your vows. There's a bit of a poet in you.
I had inspiration.
Everything changes.
Yeah, for the better. For all of us.
Maybe.
No, for all of us. I'm just the beginning. You're gonna get out soon, you'll see. I know it. And Skye, she's going to be feeling better soon. We just have to have faith.
Thank you.
The boys are getting a bit restless. I think I should take them out to the playroom.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Okay, all right.
All right. Thank you. Have a good time up there.
You're a lucky man, Stuart. Congratulations.
You're right, Tom. Thanks.
Thank you very much for coming. It made it very special.
May I kiss the bride now?
Once.
You two are just great. I wish you all the happiness in the world. You certainly look beautiful.
Thank you.
You all with weddings.
Look, there's Barbara. She came all alone. Why don't you go keep her company?
Yeah, I'll go see how she's doing.
Well, Mrs. Chandler, we did it.
Yes, we certainly did, Mr. Chandler. It was much better than I thought it would be.
Excuse me.
Oh, excuse me.
Kind of swimming against the current. I've been appointed to see that you have a good time.
Have you now? Why, that's perfect casting.
May I have the first dance?
I don't think we've ever danced before.
No.
No.
How's it going?
Oh, fine. Oh, the wedding is just lovely. I mean, the bride is gorgeous. The groom is very handsome. And the ceremony was very moving.
I'm talking about the article.
It's coming along just fine. Hillary's circulating. She's picking up some color. She's got the photographer with her.
Fine. Keep an eye on her. This may be the most important thing Temple does all year. Positive story in living with AIDS?
Yes, of course. I forgot I'm not supposed to be having a good time here. I should excuse myself and go breathe on Hillary. Excuse me.
Certainly.
Thank you.
I just wanted to thank you for the gift.
Oh, my dear, you're so very welcome. You're the loveliest bride I've ever seen.
Thank you. I'm very happy. Where are you taking me?
Quick. I wanted to do that where nobody could see me.
I feel like Ginger Rogers.
Oh, you're sure you are, and I'm Fred Astaire. You think everybody's having a good time?
Yes. Everyone's smiling at me. I haven't seen so many teeth since I worked in a dentist's office.
You worked in a dentist's office?
Mm-hmm. Before I had Scott.
Jealous. The dentist.
Well, I should have known that before we got married. Don't be. He was old and I was pregnant out to here with Scott.
No, not jealous like that. It's just when I think how long you were someplace else and I was still just here. I get sad. That's the only time I ever get sad when I'm with you, when I think how long I had to wait to find you.
Well, don't. I'm here. You're here. This is it. Everything we waited for.
Ever before. And I can just feel your love up here. Floating up like a balloon.
Given your brother a day that none of us will ever forget.
A success.
A success. And Ross is having a very good time, too.
Ah. Well, there's a good day. It's affecting everybody.
Well, you got off to a little rocky start. I was a little bit concerned for a while.
Well, I was a little nervous. I didn't want anything to go wrong.
Nothing did. I was concerned there might be a shortage of handkerchiefs there for a while. But everybody's eyes have dried very nicely.
I'm sorry. Are you all right? Natalie, I didn't...
Ross? What?
I was afraid something like that would happen. What possessed Donna to bring you here?
You know, Donna, get on with life, face the world. She can do it. I can't.
It's okay. Come with me. Sit down. Can I get you something to drink? Let me fix you a plate from the buffet table.
Food solves everything.
little pale. And thin.
Really? I thought I was a little pasty and rather fat, although I'll take pale and thin if I have a choice. Thank you.
Let me fix you something.
No, really, I don't think I could eat.
How about a dance?
I don't remember how.
Oh, I'll refresh your memory. Come. You were always my best partner.
No.
I've learned a few new steps.
I bet you did. I saw you dancing with that little brunette. You have a thing for brunettes, don't you?
You notice good. I wanted to make you jealous. That dress is beautiful. It shows the pasty fat.
Oh.
Great advantage. Come.
Duty, and I think we got our story.
Tom, I really wanted to spend more time with you. I know how hard this day is for you.
Yeah. Skye and I were married right on this spot.
I wish more than anything she can have, you can have her back with you.
I don't know if she was ever really mine. I don't know who she wanted. I don't know what she needed.
What about Tom Cudahy? What did he need?
What did I need? I needed to be married. I've never been happy not being married.
Hi, nurse. I'm Adam Chandler's nephew, Ross Chandler.
Oh, yes, Mr. Chandler.
I just wonder if I can go inside and see my cousin for a couple of seconds.
Sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. As the best man, I'm supposed to make a speech. We are here to honor the marriage of my brother and my sister-in-law. Someone who has been very close to me in every way from the moment of my birth. And someone who has become very dear to us, to Brooke and me, to all of us, in just a few short months.
Well, Skye, you could just see it downstairs. Everybody's so happy. Your father, I can't remember whenever I've seen him so happy. I mean, maybe when you... Oh, sweetheart, I don't know what's going on. So many people who love you have been by here. Stuart and Cindy. Adam, Brooke, Laura, Tom. Their love could raise you from this bed. You'd be down there dancing with them.
When Stuart and I were just boys back in West Virginia, we both had a passion for butterflies. I had a collection. And I've spent many hours every spring and summer out chasing, netting, mounting, classifying butterflies. Any butterfly that knew better would steer clear of me. Stuart, on the other hand, was just as knowledgeable as I was, but would never consider taking what is most beautiful and keeping it for himself. I swear the butterflies would actually show off their beauty for him. It was one day, and this is the truth, I saw this man walking across a field, followed by a trail of butterflies. This is true. And I knew in that moment something about beauty and life that made me throw away my net. And in many ways, Stuart has been teaching me that same lesson over and over again all our lives.
I miss you, Skye. No one was better to me. All those times you came to prison and you visited me, that meant so much. You come from a strong family, don't you? I mean, I guess that's why you did what you did, try to protect Stuart. How the hell did you get involved with Tidwell? Sorry. I shouldn't ask any questions. I'm not the one to tell anybody what to do. Someday you'll find that out. It's no good for me to tell anyone what to do.
Girls, however, were a different matter. Stuart's a little shy, or was in those days. I once asked him why he could commune with every living creature except for the girls in Pigeon Hollow. Stuart replied with great authority that girls were not nearly as smart as butterflies. Oh. And mostly not as beautiful either. I think he's changed his mind.
Stuart really deserves his happiness, Skye. He really does. He's been so good to people, especially me. As far back as I can remember, he was always... he was always there whenever I needed him.
Stuart!
He's dead, Ross.
Dead?
Not going to think about anything today, just happy thoughts. Today's a wedding day, and it's a happy day. My mother, your Aunt Lottie, she used to love weddings. It's because she never had one.
Wedding? There ain't going to be no wedding. Tramps don't get weddings.
She used to travel for miles in West Virginia to a wedding of people she...
He said the pigeons will come home to roost. The pigeons will come home to roost.
Isn't that the ugliest thing you've ever seen? I bet it's Palmer's idea of a joke. That's why there's no note. He's reminding us of our humble origin.
The pigeons will come home to roost.
Oh, my God!
So it would seem, at last, that Stuart has found a woman as smart and as beautiful as those West Virginia butterflies. And as calm and is gentle. Let's all lift our glasses to them now.
Everybody, get out of here. Take some Adam. Stuart, sit. Get out of the way. Come on. Get out of here. Take cover. Take cover.
Ah!
Ross. Jeremy, let's get this stuff out.
Ross! Ross!
Adam, don't touch him.
No. You don't know the extent, does it? Ross! He's not moving, Joe. Ross! Ross, can you hear me? Ross!
I've got to see what's happening.
Julie, you can't go out there, all right? They'll come in and let us know.
Well, it's been 10 minutes and they haven't let us know anything.
Julie, if Ross had a serious injury, believe me, they would let us know.
You know, all the time that I hated him for what he did to me and wished him dead. Now he may be. I don't want that. I don't want anybody to die.
It's all my fault. Ross could be out there dead because of me.
It's not your fault.
It's the bomb is from that organization. All these people could have been killed just because they're my friends.
Cindy, stop it.
It's bad enough that I'm going to die. I have to put all of my friends in danger, too.
Stop it. Stop it. Now, please. I know you're upset. Come on, let's go see if we can do something for the kids.
Look, I'm going to go out and see if Joe needs any help with Ross.
Yeah, you heard me. The bomb squad on the double. Now, is the ambulance on the way? Good. I want you to tell the backup to seal off the Chandler estate. Whoever planted that thing could still be on the grounds.
Watch his back. Gently,
Ross,
back
very
down.
Gently.
That's
Ross, you're going to be all right.
Anything broken, Joe?
I don't think so. Still checking for injuries.
How is he, Joe?
No, in a minute, Stuart.
Don't let anything happen to him, Edge.
Don't worry. We'll take care of him for you, Stuart.
Ambulance is on his way. How's he doing?
We don't know yet.
Stuart, why don't you go check and see how Cindy's doing, okay?
No, Ross.
Look, I'll let you know as soon as he comes around. You go on.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
Find anything?
It's nothing suspicious as far as I could tell.
I checked the help and the service people. They all check out.
Well, I'm going to double check them. It's my job.
I want this maniac found, Hubbard.
I'm working on it.
Don't blow it.
Look, you just calm down. You help me keep everybody organized, all right?
Joe, how is he? Is he hurt badly?
So far, so good, Adam.
Ross.
Cindy, you all right?
I'm a little bit shaken up like everybody else. How is Ross?
No bones broken.
I'm putting everybody at risk. We should have never gotten married. Your whole family is in danger.
Cindy, we have every right to be happy, and we're going to be.
But I'm still a target. They're going to keep coming after me.
Then we'll just keep protecting you. And we'll keep loving you and taking care of you.
Excuse me, can I have your attention? We need everybody to move out to the terrace. The bomb squad wants to check the house. It's just a precaution. I want everybody to stay calm and don't leave. The estate has been sealed off. Can I have your attention, please?
Yes.
The place has been sealed off in case this person is still on the ground. So we gotta move. Come on. Don't worry about it. Everybody calm down.
Joe, how's Ross?
Is he gonna be all right?
Few cuts and bruises. That's it.
Oh, thank God. Can I go see him, please?
No, he's gonna be coming right out. The bomb squad is still searching in there.
Jesse, do they think there could be another bomb in there?
I don't know. What you can do for me is just stay put and you'll be all right.
Yeah, any idea who did this?
I'm trying to put the pieces together now.
Well, could this person be nearby?
Well, I hope he is. And he better hope that I don't find him first.
Cindy, why don't you sit down?
No, I can't.
You shouldn't get tired out. That's important. It's time for your medicine. I'll go get it.
No, we're not supposed to go back in the house.
I'll make sure from Jesse it's okay. You gotta have your medicine.
Daddy!
Hey, darling.
Oh, I've been so worried about you. I love you.
I love you too, sweetheart. Only it hurts a little.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're
hurt. It's okay.
He just has some bruises, that's all. Ross, come sit down.
You scared me. I'm glad you're all right.
Thanks.
Ross, thank you for saving our lives.
I'm glad it all worked out.
I'm sorry I put you and all the others in any danger.
Cindy, this had nothing to do with you.
And these people, they're not going to stop at anything. They're so frightened of AIDS, they're willing to jeopardize anybody to get it.
Oh, wait. Cindy, the bomb wasn't meant for you.
Well, who else? I mean, nobody would want to hurt Stuart like this. He doesn't have any enemies.
Well, the Chandlers do, believe me. I promise you, directly or indirectly, this had nothing to do with you. There's a reason for this, and I'm going to find out.
Ross, are you up for a few questions?
Yeah, sure.
Do you want to excuse us?
Certainly.
How did you figure this thing out?
I didn't figure it out, Jesse. I was just playing a hunch.
All right, explain the hunch. How'd you put it together? What did you put together?
I'm fine. Really, I am. How's Ross?
He's going to be all right.
Good.
You okay?
I am energized beyond belief. This is a fantastic story.
Story? You're not even shook up a little bit?
I don't really have time to indulge it.
Well, I'll tell you what. When things settle down a little bit, how about I give you a lift home?
Oh, sweetie, that is really nice, but I have got to say it again. This is a dream story. I've got to cover it.
All right. Run to daylight, gamer.
Gamer?
Gamer. Yeah, you know. Like a pro. Someone who never quits until things are finished. I like that.
Oh, I'm glad you like that. But you better take this gamer back in there before the police find this thing.
In a minute. I want to go check on Skye. Skye, there's been an explosion. Everyone is okay. Ross was the one who saved the day. He's fine, too. I just thought you should know. You take care.
You can go inside. We've swept the place. It's all clear.
I'll tell the guests.
Gentlemen, you did a good job. I appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah. You got a lot of guts.
Adam, somehow it still is Pigeon Hollow.
Why don't we just forget about it for now?
Okay. Why?
Because of Cindy and Stuart. This is the biggest day of his life. This is turning into a total disaster.
I know, but this guy's got to be found.
Yes, of course we'll find him. And right now, help me turn this party around, okay?
Yeah, but some of your guests are leaving.
Oh, everybody, please. I apologize for the fact you've all been put through a terrible ordeal here today. The bomb squad assures me there's absolutely no more danger. So for the sake of our newlyweds, would you please join me and my wife and the children back inside to resume the festivities?
Yeah. That's an idea. Come on, we still have cake to eat. Let's go. Let's go eat that cake.
There you go.
Adam, maybe we should just call it a day.
Absolutely not. I never leave a celebration unfinished. You haven't had the first dance with the Stuart. You have not cut the cake. You haven't even thrown that bridal bouquet you're supposed to do. Now, come on. You're not going to cheat us out of all that, are you?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You want to dance?
Yeah.
Ross, you coming in?
Yeah, in a minute.
Thank you, Ross.
You had no idea. I know this sounds crazy, but that guy they're describing in there, I think I know him.
About Stuart, what do you mean?
He came to the hospital to see Skye, remember? And I thought I recognized him there. I don't know where or when, but somewhere I've seen him before. I know the face.
Oh, Stuart, your bride's asking for you. Adam wants to try that toast again.
Okay, I'll be right there. Just one second. I'll keep thinking about it. You coming in?
Yeah, in a second.
And as I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted, we would like to extend our hope of happiness and joy to the bride and groom, Cindy, and to Stuart.
I think it's time to cut the cake.
Oh, yeah. Oh, if you can help. Here we go.
Ready?
Have this dance?
Listen, I need all the help I can get this party back on its feet. Well, I'm smiling as loud as I can in between taking notes.
Do more. I want you to dance. I want you to mingle. I want you to tell jokes. I want you to flirt. I don't care what you do.
So, how's it coming along with Aunt Phoebe and Langley? Well, I thought for sure I could get them together during the wedding, but they're doing their stubborn old best to ignore each other. And Aunt Phoebe's over there with Joe, and Daddy's bewitching Myrtle as only he can.
Listen, this is your best chance to get the two of them together in the same room. So, come on, keep trying.
I know, but, you know, ideas are running out.
It is so good to be with you again.
You're not getting tired, are you?
No, I'm just sad because everything didn't go perfect.
It did go perfect. The ceremony was beautiful, the music is beautiful, and you're beautiful.
Well, the explosion was not beautiful.
No, but it was perfect. Awful, awful things could have happened to all our friends when that bomb went off, but nothing awful happened, don't you understand? Look at them, they're all here, everybody's fine. They're dancing and eating just like nothing happened. Not even a bomb could ruin our wedding. And nothing can ruin our honeymoon either.
Well, maybe we shouldn't go.
Of course we're gonna go. Paris is waiting. We can't disappoint it.
I need a favor from you.
Did you clear it with Adam?
That's very cute. I don't think he will even mind this one. Come here. Okay.
Yeah, uh-huh. Oh, I love it.
Joe, excuse me, but I have had my eye on this young lady all evening long. Shall we dance?
Oh, thank you.
Well, listen, go right ahead. I'll hold this. You're a man of excellent taste.
Oh, thank you.
Phoebe, what's wrong?
Well, nothing. How could anything be wrong when I'm dancing with the handsomest man in the room? Really, some people have no sense of decorum on the dance floor.
Well, they seem to be having a lot of fun. Oh, you want me to have some? Have you?
I don't know what you're doing.
Really? This is a wedding, not a beer hall.
Oh, Phoebe, they're just having a good time.
Just an empty charade. A very vulgar attempt to call attention to themselves.
I think everybody's finally getting into the swing of things.
Well, I'll be damned if I was going to let this wedding end on a glum note. Glum.
That's too much champagne.
Fantastic. This man is a hero.
No.
Ross, you're a hero.
Come on.
Yes, you are.
Stand by for phase two, Phoebe and Lightning.
So is it.
What's this all about?
Just watch.
I'm watching.
Oh, Phoebe! Will you excuse me? I haven't talked to Tom all day. Will you mind if I cut in?
Actually, I don't
mind. Oh, thank you so much.
Donna, how nice to see you again.
Well, Lightly.
Hello, Phoebe.
I see you've been abandoned for a younger man.
Youth is a state of mind, my dear.
Hogwash, my dear. Well, where are your manners? You've quite forgotten them. You could at least ask me to dance.
My manners are impeccable, and besides, you couldn't keep up with me.
Oh, is that so? Well, as they say in the vernacular, try me, Buster.
Oh, right.
Please stop that. Everyone's looking at her.
They're envious, my dear. They're envious.
They're no such thing. They just think you're making a fool of yourself.
I'm getting down on it. Come on, shake it, girl.
You are disgusting. I'll have no part of this sickening display.
Oh, stick in the mud.
That's it. I give up. Well, we did what we could.
Wait, Cindy's about to throw the bouquet. All's not lost.
All right. All you single girls, it's time for this bouquet thing, even if you think you don't want to get married.
Aunt Cindy, come on. Why don't you try to catch the bouquet? No, I'm already married, unfortunately. Barbara, aren't you going to join us?
No, I'm a little past this. Thank you very much.
Oh, so maybe you're just afraid that you might catch it.
All right, ready?
Wait. Go ahead. Oh, everybody, go ahead.
Good practice. Okay? Okay. One, two, three.
All that is left is for them to set the date.
I promise when we get back, I'm going to visit you so much you won't even know I'm gone.
All right.
Hey, you guys, you take good care of yourselves, you hear?
Yeah, I will. We owe you our lives. You were so brave. You were really brave.
Oh, come on, Stuart, we were all lucky.
You could have been killed. If anything ever happened to you, it'd hurt too much.
Nothing's going to happen to me, Stuart. You go have a great, 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 great time, okay?
And you take hundreds of pictures.
Oh,
hundreds.
We will.
Okay, good. And don't overdo it. Take good care of yourself.
Oh, there's not a chance of me overdoing it. Stuart and this guy, they take real good care of me, don't you?
Stuart, I want you to take that city by storm. Soak it all in and enjoy it. You're going to be all right. We're going to be fine. Don't worry about us. Okay. Well, Cindy, Scott, time to go.
Time to go.
Bye, everybody. Bye. Did you see how happy they were? Makes me want to get on a plane and go to Paris myself.
Yeah.
They're going to have a wonderful time. Boss, loosen up. Everything turned out very well today, thanks to you.
Yeah, thanks to me. I can't get this Tidwell out of my mind. I know. I'm not supposed to know him. I don't know him. But something connects me back to Pigeon Olive.
It's impossible.
Why is it impossible? He told me he was from the hills.
The man's a murderer. You expect him to tell you the truth?
Yes. Oh, none of that matters. Why is it, Adam? I keep getting images of Lottie, of Homer.
Sir, there's no connection. What possible connection could there be? There is no connection between Tidwell and them.
There is for me.
Well, that's nonsense, Ross. Lottie and Homer are gone. There's nothing we can do about that. But to make some kind of a blind jump, trying to connect them with Tidwell and that bomb, it's an exercise in futility. Let it go.
Did you finish covering the story?
Oh, yes, down to the very last detail.
Well, I know your car's in the shop. You'll be needing a ride home.
I was just going to call a cab.
Oh, I hate cabs. Smelly, uncomfortable, rude drivers.
Now, you don't think it might set the suburban tongues a-wagging?
I would be unfriendly if I didn't offer. It's a wedding. We're both friends of Cindy and Stuart.
Aunt Phoebe!
Hillary, dear, would you be a darling and give me a lift home?
Home? Not with the party is still going on. What are you talking about?
I've had quite enough of celebrating.
Well, Aunt Phoebe, I mean, lots of people are still here. Look, there's Langley and Myrtle and...
The party is over.
But...
Are you going to take me home, or are you going to force me to make some kind of scene?
Looks like I'll be taking you home.
Thank you.
Mets or the Yankees take on Oakland tonight on the season premiere of the ABC's Monday Night Baseball.
Wednesday, watch Class Act, a teacher's story on the ABC After School Special.